Hey, good day, good day, good day. Thanks for joining me. Just in case you're joining me for the very first time, I'm your host, the one they call Brian Glaze Gibbs. And listen, my story is my ministry. I talk about the good, I talk about the bad, I talk about the ugly. I try to get people to listen to the words that come out of my mouth, to get them to understand that crime doesn't pay, there's no shortcut. The difference is when you're out there and you're trying to hustle illegally, only thing you're going to end up in that jail cell. Only thing you're going to end up in an early grave. So the difference is, I am not your typical minister, but what I try to do is I try to tell the truth. I speak about things that I know and are based upon my experience. So once again, like I say, thank you for joining me. Hit that like button, subscribe to my YouTube channel, follow me on Instagram, Brian Glaze Gibbs, and right now, email me. Listen, today what I'm going to talk about, special shout out, man. Special shout out to my man, this brother right here, Wayne Pray, Akbar, okay? Akbar is a living legend. What I'm saying right now is he's from Newark, New Jersey, and right now a great guy. And don't get me wrong, like I told you, I had the opportunity to meet Akbar back in 1988 when I caught my Fed beef in MCC New York. He was charged, like I was charged at 848. He was charged at 848, but he'd been in the game for years. And like, you know, everybody talked about his extravagant lifestyle, the Rolls Royce, the Bentleys, the fur coat, the jewelry, the houses in California, houses in Florida, houses in New Jersey, like, you know, everything that he was into or whatever. And to me, like, you know what? Here it is, they talk about how many like tons of kilo that, you know, I'm talking about marijuana, cocaine, that, you know, was smuggling by him and his organization and moved throughout, you know what I'm saying, the whole East and West Coast border. But to me, like, I'm speaking about the individual that I know. And to me, when I met him, he was like, you know, a father figure. He was like a smooth, down-to-earth, cool brother. And the difference is, the surprising part was, like, when I got to MCC and my crew, you know, like, doing a conversation, like, what he was amazed about was the fact, like, hold on, wait a minute, man. Now, I heard about y'all guys. And y'all guys, you know, right now, you're thinking, because he was, like, in his 40s at the time. So, at that time, I had just turned 25. So, he's saying, like, out of all the stuff that I'm hearing about y'all guys, I'm thinking y'all guys is, you know, like my age, like 30, 40, 50 years old. Y'all cats, you know, really babies, which was true. We was young, dumb kids that was out there trying to be grown-ups, trying to do stuff that we shouldn't be out there in the first place. But the difference is when you get caught up into that fast world and you want to be down and you look up to somebody like an Akbar, I like a Nicky Barnes, I like a Pee Wee Kirkland, like a New York Freddy. You know, these are the people that you look up to, you know, Frank Matthew. Because once again, these are folks that you look at as successful individual, successful black man, but committing what? They doing and poisoning their community. You know, they making a living and they helping other people, but what are they doing in the process? And the difference is right now is, here it is, despite, you know, these brothers did that, even with me. And the folks that's out there, the difference is, long as you're able to understand that your behavior and your action was wrong, then that's something totally different. Because what you have to do is, you have to be honest with yourself. Even now, like I told you, Akbar been incarcerated since 1988, you know? And they working on trying to get him some type of form of clemency due to health reason. Akbar, I'm talking about, since he been in there, guess what? You know, he got his life together. Highly intelligent brother. Helped so many other individuals, younger brothers, you know what I'm saying, get their degree, you know what I'm saying, GED, help them with college courses. He helped them. Right now is, he helped, wrote several books and out there doing little, sending out like voice recording of different, like, you know what I'm saying, like philosophy and what should be utilized and how to counterattack, you know what I'm saying, today, you know what I'm saying, crime problem. The brother's doing an outstanding job. And sometime right now is, let he or she, while sin cast the first stone, we all make mistakes. But the difference is, sometimes the mistake that you made do not have to be permanent. Sometimes the mistake that you made, you know what I'm saying, do not have to warrant a life sentence or warrant the death penalty. The difference is right now is, guess what? The brother have changed. The brother is helping other individuals get their life together. And you know what? Like I told you, man, like, anybody that I know that know Akbar, if you can't get along with Akbar, you can't get along with anybody. Because once again, man, humble individual. Despite he was who he was, well-respected, guess what, man? The way he presented himself, you have no other choice but to respect him. That's why I call him the man, the myth, the legend. And I wish him nothing but the best, him and his family. And hopefully right now is the brother is released real soon. Because that's what life is all about, man. You know what? This is who he used to be. Okay? That's who he used to be. Okay? And this is who he is now. Okay? Time bring about change. Time bring about growth. Time bring about the opportunity that you get a chance to look yourself in the eye and see where you went wrong at and what can you do to correct your behavior and your past misdeed. And that's the difference. A lot of us have to do that. But the difference is right now, honestly, how many of us have lived in the life of a lie? You know, me, I'm guilty of that. A lot of us is guilty of living the life of a lie. Because once again, we can't even be honest with ourselves. So how the heck we expect to be honest with people, relationship, co-workers, kids? How can you be honest with anybody if you can't be honest with yourself? A lot of times right now, we have to do a lot of soul searching. And the difference right now is how in the heck we was out there committing crimes. You know, what we have to do is we have to get a better understanding of who we are, what we are, and that we can do better. We can do better if we want to do better, but we have to apply ourselves. We can't live in the past. Well, you know, my father sold drugs. Or my uncle brother was a stick up kid. Or, you know what I'm saying? My grandfather was a killer. No, what happened? Change that. You know what I'm saying? What happened to my uncle, you know what I'm saying? Brother was a doctor. What happened to my father, you know what I'm saying right now, was a doctor. What happened to my uncle? My first cousin was a judge. You know, it's all about right now changing our mindset. Believing that we can do all things through Christ which strengthens us. Stop having that negative, you know what I'm saying, attitude and demeanor about life. Start right now living in our word in existence, talking out the word into existence. Start believing in the words that are coming out of our mouth. Make sure that we eliminate all negativity out of our life. So just like I said right now, man, listen, if you sit back and you watch this brother, you know what? Change, man. Change comes from within, man. You know what I'm saying? Right now is here it is. He did what he had to do. You know what I'm saying? For the time being, to take care of his family. And guess what, man? The brother changed. You know what? The same way I have changed. And the difference is, you know what took me to change? Pain. Being away, losing my mother. Being incarcerated, couldn't go to the funeral. And I had nobody to blame but myself. Because I was out there picking up the brick, throwing at that prison wall, wanting to be down, wanting to be cool. Cool for what? Who I wasn't trying to impress. The difference is I was living a life of a lie. You know what I'm saying? Living a life of a lie. Like Keith Sweat say, are you living a life of a lie? Is that magic gone? Ooh, do you feel the same way you used to? No, living a life of a lie. In order to be honest with anybody else, you got to be honest with yourself. You got to look yourself in the eyes. Look yourself in the eyes. Be honest with yourself. Sometimes you're not going to like what you see, but the difference is right now, man, how can you be honest with anybody else if you're not being honest with yourself? And that's the day message, man. The bottom line is right now, shout out to the legend, you know what I'm saying? Wayne, Pray, Akbar, happy belated birthday, man. Hopefully right now, God bless you with your freedom soon to be back with your family, man. And like I tell you folks, listen, man, be honest with yourself, man. How can you be honest with your wife, your girlfriend, your husband, you know what I'm saying, your kids? If you can't be honest with yourself, if you've been living a life alive all your life, it got to stop, man. It got to start from somewhere. Listen, check me out. Get your signed copy of the Beyond Lucky Book, the Brian Glaze Gibbs story, a true story of change and redemption. If I, the one Brian Glaze Gibbs, can change, anybody can change. Email me at Brian, B-R-I-A-N, Gibbs, G-I-B-B-S, 1201 at yahoo.com and get your signed copy. You will not be disappointed. Share my story. This will help your kid, my kid, your grandkids, your nieces, your nephew. It will help them stop making that multi-billion dollar prison system their permanent address. There's no shortcut in life. Only thing come fast is trouble. Easy to get into and hard to get out. Okay? So that's why you got to let everybody know it. That's it. That's what it's all about. Peace, love, and prosperity. Thank you for joining me.